Nothing special.
Ah, I see. Okay, how's the weather right now?
It's cloudy and not too hot.
Very good. Okay, so today, Pinky, we're going to continue our lesson in Unit 3, but if you can remember the lesson that we had last time, what did we do?
I forget it.
You forgot about it. Okay, so give me a second. I'm just checking which part are we now? Okay, so anyway, are you very busy at school these days?
Yes.
Ah, okay. What are you up to in school, Pinky?
I study a school 5 lessons each day, and 1 2-hour lesson in the afternoon each day.
Pardon?
I study 5 lessons in the morning and 1 2-hour lesson in the afternoon each day.
Ah, okay. So yeah, you have a very busy schedule in school. So, okay, going back to our lesson, Pinky, we are now in vocabulary part. But I think we've started some of the vocabulary in here. We are done with the first set. So let's move on with this one. Okay, so look at this one, Pinky. So what's the duvet for?
We use it to make our body warm in the winter.
Yes, that's right. Do you use a duvet in your bedroom, Pinky?
Yes.
Oh, nice. Okay, so what are the things that you can find in your bedroom that are in here?
In my bedroom, I can find the chest of drawers, duvet and wardrobe.
Very good. Okay, what do you put in your chest of drawers?
I put
Bye.
the paper and books and some small things.
All right. Okay, what about in your wardrobe?
In my wardrobe, I put my clothes, my summer clothes and my winter clothes.
Ah, okay. So you have some winter clothes. Is there a winter season in your place?
It has 2 drawers. It has 2 drawers, and I put my summer in the first drawer and my winter clothes in the second one.
Ah, oh, I see. Okay, so thank you for sharing that one, Pinky. So now let's move on with the vocabulary and grammar review in Unit 2. Okay. Oh. Yeah, I think this one is done.
Yes.
Hold on. This one is done too. And this one is also done. So I think the next one is something that we haven't started with yet. Okay, so let's continue with grammar part 4. So this time, Pinky, you're going to complete the sentences with the words inside the rectangular box below. So there are actually extra words that you don't need, so be careful in choosing your answer. So what is number one, Pinky?
When my mom was younger, she used to play basketball at school. In
All right.
at primary school, I didn't use to have lunch at school?
Used with letter D at the end.
I didn't use to have lunch at school.
Which kind of used in here with the past tense or the present simple?
Present simple.
Very good. What about number three?
Number three is when Mr. Marsden was our teacher, he used to give us a lot of homework.
Yes. Okay, four.
Before Eva bought an alarm clock, she before she used to be late for school.
Very good. And lastly,
Lastly, my grandparents weren't used to watch TV because they didn't have one.
okay, so this is didn't. My parents didn't use to watch TV because they didn't have one. Okay, so this is actually a good score, not bad at all. So almost perfect score. That is 4 out of 5, Pinky. Nice. Okay, so I will still give you 1 star for that one for exerting an effort. So finally, we are done with unit 3. So now is the time that we will move on with unit 4. Okay, can you guess what the topic in unit 4 is all about, Pinky?
No.
No. Okay, so if we learn about present simple, past continuous, present continuous, so what's going to be in unit 4? Any guesses? Okay, so it says in here that Unit 4 is all about having fun. This is only the title, but we don't know yet what the content inside Unit 4. Okay, so let's look at this one, Pinky. Let's have a warm up. So let's watch this video. Okay, so I think this is not necessary to play Pinky because this is just a song for kindergarten and you're no longer in kindergarten anymore. So let's move on with that song. So let's look at the leisure activities in here. Okay, but before we go through with each of the phrases, let's define what is leisure activity, Pinky. Any idea?
We do leisure activities for entertainment.
That is right. Okay, so from the word leisure, it entertain us, it makes us happy, and this is the thing, this is an activity that we do in our free time because it makes us happy and it is fun to do this kind of activity. Okay, so first we have in here,
Diving in the sea.
Diving in the sea.
yes, have you ever dived in the sea, Pinky?
I don't think it's diving because I just wear special glasses then swam out to the sea and swim out to the sea and call and view the coral.
Yes, actually, this is not really diving in the sea. You're correct because we call it scuba diving, like this one. And this equipment at the back of the woman is what we call an oxygen tank. So this will help you to breathe deep down in a water. Okay, I know about this one because I've tried scuba diving once and it was actually a worth it experience of mine because the corals were so nice and what's that? There were small fish under the coral, and I've also seen some other sea creatures in the ocean, but we only dived 60 meters below. 60 meters below, we didn't dive in a very deep ocean because that area is a bit dangerous. And if you're gonna ask me if I'm gonna try it again, yes, I would love to do it again. Okay, I was so brave because a little trivia about me, I don't know how to swim, but I don't know where did I get my courage during that time when I tried scuba diving, even though that I don't know how to swim. Yes, because actually there is also an instructor who would go with you, and they will tell you, they will train you or orient you before they will let you dive into the sea. And it's not really like dive because you are like tumbling backwards. You don't dive like a literal dive like what swimmers do. You just what do we call that one? Like back tumbling from the boat deep down to the sea. Yes. And we cannot talk when you are deep down the ocean. You just do some symbols. Yes, like okay symbols like that, or help symbols you have to tap. So they will teach you some symbols so that you'll be able to communicate with each other like that. Okay, and we have in here the next one, Pinky.
Doing sports. Doing sports.
Yes. Okay, can you name some sports that you like?
I like badminton, basketball, and pickleball.
What's that?
Pickleball, is go viral, and it's going viral. It is a combination between tennis and ping pong.
Okay. So it is similar to ping pong, right?
We play it like tennis, but we use the racket and the plastic ball like ping pong.
Okay, but not really ping pong. I
Yeah.
have it actually, it is my first time hearing about that sport because I think it's not maybe there are some who play who play that sports in the Philippines, but I'm not familiar with it. But thank you for sharing that one, Pinky. Okay, and how important is doing sport, Pinky?
We do sports to strengthen our muscles and our body in shape.
That is right. Okay, how often do you play badminton?
I play badminton when I am free. I don't have a schedule.
Okay, great. Who do you play with?
I play with my brother and my mom.
Very good. Okay, great, Pinky, because it's also like an exercise for you and a quality time with your family, especially your mom and
Diving
brother.
in the sea.
Okay, and lastly, we have here.
Going dancing. Going dancing.
Yes, do you like dancing, Pinky?
I like it a little. But I don't dance much.
Do you have a TikTok account?
Yes.
Okay, do you dance in TikTok?
No, I just watch.
Yeah, same thing with me too. Oh, actually, I post a video in TikTok, but just some short clips about me teaching. Yes, just to market myself to attract private students of mine like that. But I don't dance in TikTok. I don't show my face in TikTok. Yeah, and I just use my name, which is Teacher AM. I don't use my real name in TikTok. And if I want to watch some other users' video, then yeah, I will just use that account instead. Yeah, but you know, my two sisters have TikTok accounts and they do dance. Yeah, because they're good at dancing, but me, I'm not good at dancing, so that's why I don't dance. Okay,
Doing
so
sports.
next we have in
Playing
here.
computer game.
Playing computer game.
Yes, okay, do you play some computer game?
I don't play games much. I just surf the internet.
Very good, because when you like playing computer game and you cannot control yourself, then it becomes an addiction, which is actually a serious matter these days. Yeah, because many children get addicted to playing computer game, and it actually affects their academic performance, which is actually terrible. Okay, what are some computer games that you know, Pinky?
Just like Roblox, Arena of Valor, Legends of Ryu, and Free Fire, yes, and Subway Surfers, and many, many more.
Yes, among the games that you mentioned, I only know how to play one game, which is Subway Surfers. Like that. I'm familiar with Roblox, but I don't know how to play it. And I know Roblox because of my nephew. He likes playing Roblox. Okay, and next phrase we have
Posting
here.
messages on social media sites.
Posting messages on social media sites.
Yes. What are the social media that you have, social media account that you have, Pinky?
I have Facebook, Messengers, Instagram, TikTok, Pinterest, and some and YouTube.
Very good. Oh, you have a YouTube too. Okay, what do you do on YouTube?
Sometimes I watch cartoons on it, or I improve my listening skills by listening to it. Don't you know?
Who is that?
TEDx.
Yeah, TEDx.
Yes.
Yes, I know. Very
It's
good, Pinky.
very is beneficial, and I also have a Spotify account, and I listen to TEDx or post some podcasts on it.
Very good. So that is actually one of the most effective way to improve your listening skill in English. Yes. And you can also learn while listening to it. Yes. Okay. So actually TEDx has TEDx talks cover a wide range of subject. It could be education, technology, what else? Personal development, professional growth. Yeah, like many subjects. So what subject in TEDx do you like listening to or watching to?
Listening, I listen a lot of video and some and podcasts. So, I just listen to improve. I don't. I it is don't necessary to choose a topic or listen.
Wow. Okay. So I understand that one, Pinky. Okay, so in which social media account do you like posting?
I like, I don't often post on my social media account. Sometimes I post my story on Facebook.
Yes, same with me too. Okay, so just in Facebook, you are active in Facebook when you post a story, right? But with your other social media account, you don't like posting. You're just a user.
Can you ask again?
Oh, I'm sorry, that was complicated. Like, yeah, what I understand, it's not even a question. It's not a question, Pinky. It's just a statement. So, the only social media account that you are active with is Facebook because you post stories. But with your other social media accounts, you're not really active there. You don't like posting there because you're just a user, right?
Yeah.
Ah, that's really nice, Pinky. Why is it that you don't like posting in some of your social media accounts?
Because am embarrassed and I don't want to post, I just watch.
Ah, I understand. Actually, that is one thing to be safe in social media, and no one can use your information or can steal your information from you because you don't post anything about yourself like that. So keep it up, Pinky. And lastly, we have
Riding a
here.
bike or a horse.
Riding a bike or a horse.
Yes, okay. So which do you prefer, Pinky? Riding a bike or riding a horse?
I like riding a bike.
Very good. Why is that?
Because it is not as dangerous as riding a horse.
Yes, that is right. Because with the bike, you have the control of it. The horse. Okay, when you ride a horse, you still have the control, but sometimes it is out of your control because the horse wants to go somewhere else. Yeah, me too. You know, I like riding a horse. It's just that I am too scared to do it. So I'd rather ride a bike instead. Okay. And next phrase we have.
Seeing friends.
Seeing friends.
Yes, how often do you meet your friends, Pinky?
I meet my friends almost all the days in a week.
Yes, because they are in the same school, they are from the same school as you go, right?
Yeah.
Yes. Okay, how important is having a schedule to meet your friends?
What?
How important it is to have a schedule in meeting your friends?
I don't have schedule because I go to school almost all I go to school all day, so I can meet my friends whoever.
I understand. Yeah, that's actually one of the advantages of being a student because you have many friends. You can talk to them anytime because you belong in the same school. But you know what? Once you become a professional, Pinky, it's very important to schedule a time on when to meet your friends so that you can catch up. Yes, and you can also stay connected with each other, even though that you are all busy with your career. Yes, and me, it has been a year that I haven't met my friends because one of my friend is already in the US, one is in Singapore, the other one is still in the Philippines but busy with her baby. And me too, I am busy as a student and as a teacher teaching like that. So yeah, so we have our own priorities, so it's kind of hard to schedule a time. But thankfully, we feel close to each other because of technology. So we just chat with each other in our group chat or have some video calls instead.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, and lastly we
Taking
have,
photos.
Taking photos.
yes, do you like taking photos, Pinky?
I don't like taking photos. I don't like selfie much. I just like taking photos about the scenes or some trees in the jungle.
Okay. And what do you do with those photos? Do you post?
No, I often post my drawing.
You're drawing. Very good. Okay, thank you for sharing that one, Pinky. So this time, let's start off. Let's complete the leisure activities with the verbs from the box. And which activities can you see in the photos later on? Okay, so number one, we have here doing sports. What about number two?
Number two is taking photos.
Nice. Three.
Number three is doing dancing.
Very good. Four.
Number four is riding a bike or a horse.
Fantastic. Five.
Number five is playing computer games.
Brilliant. Six.
Six is seeing friends.
Great job. Seven.
Seven is posting messages on social media sites.
That's right. And lastly,
Diving in the sea.
wow, well done, Pinky. That is a perfect score. Eight. Out of eight. So very easy for you. So I'm gonna give you 2 stars for that one. Okay, nice. Now what about here, Pinky? Let's look at the photos. So what are the photos that you can see in here?
Letter A is doing dancing.
Very good.
Letter B is diving in the sea.
That's right.
Letter C is riding a bike.
Great job. Letter D.
Letter D is riding a horse.
Yes, and lastly,
Lastly is playing computer games.
yes, very good, Pinky. Okay, so this time I want you to answer a question. What is the best way to spend your time? Okay, and you put the leisure activities in order. You can put one to the activity that you think is the best way to spend your free time, and five to the activity that you think is the least way to spend your free time. Okay. So let's go back. You can,
No, you go on.
What?
I don't understand the exercise.
Instruction. Okay. So you can see five pictures in here. So I'm gonna ask you a question. Which activity do you think is the best way to spend your free time? So you write numbers in order. For example, if you think that riding a horse is the best way to spend your free time, then you put number one to that. And if you think that scuba diving is the least way to spend your free time, put number five. Then tell me, why do you choose one and number five? But you can actually like put one, two, three, four, five. And I will ask you late a question later on.
Yeah, number one is playing computer games.
All right.
Number two is doing dancing.
Okay.
Number three is riding a bike.
Very good.
Number four is diving.
And lastly,
And lastly is riding horse.
very good. So, Pinky, share to me your thoughts. Why do you choose playing computer games is the best way to spend your free time?
I don't know because it's the most entertaining.
All right. What about why do you choose riding a horse as the least way to spend your free time?
Sorry, but can you ask again, please?
Oh, why do you put number five to riding a horse?
Because I don't like riding a horse.
Yeah, so as simple as that, and it explains. So very good, Pinky. Thank you so much for sharing your answers to me. Okay, so this time I'm gonna ask you a question. Then I encourage you to talk more. Okay, which other leisure activities do young people in Vietnam enjoy and why?
I don't know because I think they like most teenagers like surfing TikTok and or seeing friends. I don't know because it depends on each person and I don't know what they like.
Yes, that is right, because each individual has its own interest. I might like being on TikTok, but you might not like it because you prefer playing badminton. So it actually depends on their interest. Very good, Pinky. Okay, so are these activities difficult to learn?
Surfing TikTok and seeing friends.
Yeah,
I
those
don't
two.
think anything they are difficult to learn. And we don't have to learn to surf TikTok and see friends. It's good.
Yes. Okay. And it's very convenient for us to do that because we don't have to go to another place to do that. As long as we have the phone and the Wi-Fi, then we can do those leisure activities. What about for grown-ups, Pinky, like our grandpa? Do you think those activities are difficult for them to learn? Why or why not?
I think it's not difficult.
Ah, for our grandparents?
Yeah.
Ah, okay. So, yeah, it depends. How old are your grandparents, Pinky?
They are 7,
They are
75 years old.
Oh wow, but it's very easy for them to use tech mobile phones.
Huh? What?
Oh, but I'm sorry, Pinky. Do they have mobile phones?
Yes.
Oh, wow, that's really I am amazed because they are updated to what's going on, especially with the technology. You know what? My mom is my mom could barely use her smartphone without asking a question. Yeah, because she doesn't know how to do it. She knows how to read, she knows how to write, but she doesn't know how to search someone on Facebook so that she can message it. She doesn't know how to go to their group chat like that. So we really have to teach her. Yeah. So if my parents, if my grandparents were still alive, I think they will also have difficulty in learning TikTok and doing some leisure activities that has to do with social media like that. So that is only my thought about it, Pinky. But yeah, you are also correct when you said that it's gonna be easy for them. Okay, maybe they are exposed to technology. That's why it's very easy for them. It's like basic for them. Okay, so here, Pinky, how much time a week do you spend doing your favorite leisure activity?
My, I, I don't know because I am very busy and each day I often spend my I spend my lunch break at home to surf the internet. Then I go to school and in the evening I do my homework and revise the next lesson.
Very good. Okay, so now Pinky, let's move on with listening part four in here. Okay, so look at the photo of a boy skateboarding and the photo of a building. Huh? I think this one is done, right? Are you familiar with this with these pictures, Pinky?
Yeah.
Yeah, I think we finished this one, right? But why is it that this is in unit four? Okay, let me see. Ah, so yeah, this is actually done.
Yeah.
Oh, I am confused now. Okay, because as I remember, before we started with the practice test of PET, we are done with, we haven't finished unit two. That's why to make sure we started with unit three. Yes, and since we finished unit three just today, that's why we get started with unit four. Okay, but let me start with unit five instead. Give me a second, Pinky. I will just download the material instead.
Yeah.
Unit five. Okay, so what while waiting, Pinky, let's talk. What are you going to do after our class?
I forgot. Because we did some, we have done some tests recently.
Ah, okay. So in what grading are you now? Are you in the third grade? I know, I mean, in are you now in the fourth quarter or third quarter of the school semester of the school year?
Yeah.
Okay, Are you Pinky?
Yes.
When your school year ends?
My school years end in the on in September in 2025.
Okay. So next year, so you still have a long way to go. But yeah, time flies so fast. Okay, anyway, this is now the next part, the next unit of Unit 4, which is a review of Unit 3 and 4. So let's see. Okay, so choose the correct preposition in italic. Okay, so number one is given, in class, I sit between two friends. So the three of us are all in the front row. So what about number two, Pinky?
Number two is near my school.
Very good. How about number three?
Number three is above.
Above. All right. Four.
Number four is in front of.
Very good. Five.
Number five is under.
Nice. Okay, six.
We ran inside the shop when the rain started.
Yes, perfect for that one, Pinky. Okay, now this time match the beginnings of the sentences together with the endings. For example, I'm going to put my name down for swimming lessons. What about number two, Pinky?
We are really looking forward to surfing tomorrow.
That's right. Okay, E. Oh, letter number three.
Number three, who people who like art often take of painting as a hobby.
That's right. Okay, four.
I'm sure that you can deal.
Oh, number four. I need to find.
I need to find out. I need to find out some information for my homework.
That's right. Okay, five.
I'm sure that you can deal with any problems like that.
Nice. Okay, six.
In the next game, you can join in and play for our team.
Great job. Seven.
It's a long walk, so I need to set off very early in the morning.
Nice. And lastly,
If I spend too much, I will run out of money soon.
yes, wow, perfect, Pinky. So this is just a piece of cake for you. 8 out of 8. Nice. Okay, now this time you choose the correct option from the choices below. So number one is already given. While I'm away, a neighbor is looking after our cat. So what about number two?
Number two is collection.
Wow, my brother has a wonderful collection of old coins. Great. Three.
My brother is a very good cook.
Nice. Okay, four.
I want to learn the piano
The.
or another musical instrument.
Nice. Okay, five.
The bus. Fee for children is much lower than for adults.
Okay, A, B, or okay, fee or fare?
Fee.
Fee. Actually, this is letter B, fare. Bus fare, like that. Okay, like how much is the fare? That's fair. Okay, what about number six?
It's more fun to take part in a game than just watch it.
Yes, that is right. So almost perfect, Pinky. That's also a good score. 5 out of 6. Nice. Okay, so in part 4, let's complete the email from Arya to Louise. Okay, by writing ing or the infinitive form of the verb inside the bracket. So number 1 is given. This is an infinitive form. I'm planning to go. Okay, now look at the email, read, and complete it. You
Hi,
can do it,
Louise.
Pinky.
Hi, Louise. I'm planning to go away on holiday next week, but there are still so many things I need to do before I leave. I want to take some new clothes with me, but I can't afford to buy expensive things. Actually, I actually don't feel like spending anything at all. So now I decided to borrow some clothes from my sister. I'm sure she won't mind. I'm also hoping to see my friends here before I go, so I suggested spending Sunday afternoon together. When I'm away, I must remember to send you photos. I forgot doing that last summer, but I promise I will this time. See you on public area.
Yes, thank you so much for this one, Pinky. So actually, the number 10, this is doing. I forgot doing that last summer. I forgot to do that. Ah, it's better to do. To do is better than doing. Okay, because it happened last summer already. So I forgot to do. So yes, still an almost perfect score. So not bad, Pinky. Okay, now I'm gonna ask you a question. What does Arya plan to do next week?
I plan to just a normal week. I go to school, then go home and go to the extra classes.
All right. What about Arya, the one who wrote this email? What does she plan to do next week?
She planned to go away on holiday next week.
That's right. Okay. So let's look at with vocabulary unit in vocabulary review and grammar review in unit 4. Okay. So in here, Pinky, I want you to complete Clara's email with adjectives in the correct form. So look, the first letter of each word is already there. And there is one space for each letter in the word. So if there are 5 spaces, then one letter is given. So that means that word has 6 letters. So that's how you do it. So this letter is from Clara to George. Look and complete it.
Hi Josh, I live in Bilbao, which is a very large city in Spain. In fact, it is the biggest city in the area. Bilbao is 1 is
I think this one is great.
It's great. I love it. It's located on the north coast and it can be quite rainy. April is by far the winter month, but January is wettest, but January is the coldest month.
Very good.
Last January was 4 foggy. Temperatures fell to
Okay, so this one is negative 20 degrees Celsius.
Negative 20 degrees Celsius. As for the city itself, Bilbao is absolutely fascinating. I love shopping, and there are many places to go in the city center. My friends love the shopping center. It's always fun and fun. Lively. I prefer E Y car
El
L
Corte.
quarter Eagles is a huge department store. Tourists usually visit the Yoshihan Museum, but I think it's a bit boring. Why don't you come and visit me? Hope to hear from you soon. Lots of love, Clara.
Yes, thank you so much for completing the email, Pinky. So since it's already time, so we'll just call it a night and see you next week. Bye-bye, Pinky.
Goodbye, teacher.